everyone! Today I'm going to transform myself into the Mona Lisa. We're going to get started by concealing our eyebrows with a glue stick. You're going to need to coat all your eyebrow hairs in order for them to lay as flat as possible on your face. Also, don't be afraid to use some pressure to lay the hairs flat. Wait until the glue has dried clear before adding another layer. And for my very thick eyebrows, I used about 3 layers of glue. Now you're going to take the thickest, fullest coverage foundation that you have. I am using a foundation stick. This is going to cover nearly everything: blemishes, dark circles, my eyebrows. That's why you need a very full coverage foundation, and take it down to your neck. If you're using something that's way lighter than your natural skin tone, then you have to take it down to your chest, but my chest is pretty light, so I can just take it down to my neck and it'll be all right. And I'm just using a synthetic and dense foundation brush to just blend everything out, because you really want to have a really flat face for right now. Now it's time to set all that foundation with some powder, and make sure to do a stamping motion, that way you're not moving the product around, which would suck, especially if you worked so hard to acquire a flawless look. Now we're going to take a foundation that's way darker than your natural skin tone, and you're going to use that to create shading around your face, just like on the painting itself. And I'm looking at the painting and just kind of guiding myself through the painting, just trying to replicate what's going on there. So I'm going around my temples, on my cheekbones, and also on the jaw area. It's gonna look a little bit crazy, but trust me, it'll start looking a little bit more normal once you blend everything out. And I'm just using the same brush that I used to blend out the foundation. Crazy. Ladies and gentlemen, this is not the Kim K contour. This is a painting. So that's why it's gonna look a little bit odd, but it'll look better once we're done with this. Now we're gonna move on to the eyes, and we're gonna start with a cream colored matte eyeshadow all over the lid. Now I'm going to create a rough outline of the shape that's on the eye area. So it's kind of an almond type of shape going on, and I'm using a light matte brown eyeshadow to create that rough outline. I find that it's a lot easier to create the look when you have kind of an outline all sketched out, and then you can go in and actually start blending and creating the multi-dimensional shading. So now I'm taking more of the light brown and just kind of creating a little bit more shade. Little by little, we're gonna create layers of shading so it can look more like the painting itself. Now I'm taking a deeper matte brown eyeshadow, and I'm gonna start creating more depth in the eye area. So I'm gonna start blending it on the mock crease that we made above our natural crease, and also in the inner corner of the eyes. I'm just creating some more depth. And finally, I'm adding just a hint of black on the outside corner of the eye. Just a little bit, you don't need that much. Before you go on and start blending out those harsh edges, you want to make sure the brush is completely clean, so just wipe it on a towel, and that will take care of all the eyeshadows. And to help you out on the blending out process, you can use the same matte cream eyeshadow that we used on the lids, and that will help you out a lot. Trust me, a lot. And the Mona Lisa has some puffy eyes, so I'm just creating some shadow underneath my own puffy eyes to enhance that and make them look young and puffy and just like the painting. So enhance those puffy eyes. Now we're gonna do some contouring around our nostrils, which sounds very, very strange, and it looks a little bit strange, but that's what we have to do to look like the Mona Lisa. You have to contour those nostrils, girl. And now I'm adding just a hint of a peachy nude because I felt like it looked a little bit dead with the concealer lips, so there we go. And now you're the Mona Lisa. You can either buy a wig. Mine wig sucked. I hated it, but there we go. I am the Mona Lisa, the Mona Laura, La Gioconda, La Gioconda, whatever you want to call it. You're a piece of art. So practice that Mona Lisa smile. And yeah, that's going to be a lot of makeup in Halloween. But now we're going to take it all off using the Neutrogena Cleansing Towelettes, which is one of my favorite products to remove my makeup. We're going to take off that wig, take off all that makeup, because you have to let your skin breathe after Halloween. After all, I think it deserves to breathe afterwards. So I'm just going to be using one wipe to remove every single stitch of makeup. It is incredible. That's why I love these wipes, and you can easily find them at your local Walmart. Super easy, and yeah, just one wipe. They're super moist. They just grab a hold of all the makeup that's stuck on your face. Maybe not the glue stick, but that one you can just like peel it off with your fingernail and it should come off relatively easy. What did I tell you? It's coming off relatively easy. I told you, you do not have to be worried about gluing down your eyebrows because that glue will come off very easily. And that's pretty much it for this Mona Lisa makeup tutorial. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. I had a blast creating this look. Please let me know if you liked it in the comments below. And I will see you guys very soon in my next video. All the product information will be down below in the information box for you. So I will see you guys very, very soon in my next video. Bye!